This video about Ubuntu Linux system settings and configuration. Okay, to open settings, you have two options. First, click this arrow and hit settings. Okay, or go to show applications and choose setting. If you can't see it, just filter using setting and it will be opened again. Okay, now this is all the system configuration for normal user. Okay, and by normal user I mean the home user or the user who is dealing with the GUI, graphical user interface. Okay, let's review this configurations or settings one by one. Okay, first one is network, and for network, and this is for your network connection. Okay, we have a wired network connection here, and to connect or disconnect it by software, this is a switch button for this purpose. Okay, and click setting to view the network settings, and here we have information about our connection, the link speed, and the IP address assigned to this machine by the router, and we have the default route or gateway and the default DNS. Okay, and this connection is connect automatically as soon as you plug your socket, it will be connected. Okay, and it's available for all users, and by users I mean user 1, user 2, user 3 on this machine. Okay, and this is the name of this machine, and you can change this name. And for IP version 4 configuration, just make it automatic DHCP, which stand for dynamic host configuration protocol, to be assigned by the router, because if you are not a system administrator or software engineer or network engineer, you will not be able to assign this IP correctly. Okay, and to not have a problems. Okay, and this tab for IP version 6, normally it doesn't work till now. Okay, and this is for network, and also we have a Bluetooth connection here. If you have a Bluetooth in your machine, laptop or desktop, it will be detected by the system configuration. Okay, now for background, and background we mean the desktop wallpaper. Okay, you can change the desktop image, it has been changed immediately. Okay, as you can see, and also you can choose a picture stored in your file manager. Okay, now for appearance, and appearance it used to customize your theme, and for theme we have a dark mode. Okay, and we have a standard mode, a combination between light and dark mode, and we have a light mode. Okay, and now for icons, increase the size of icons or decrease the size of icons, you can customize it. And auto hide dock, and it used to hide the dock, and I mean the dock, it's supposed to be the launcher. Okay, but it will be appear after we close this this setting. Okay, now for launcher, we can make launcher at bottom or right or left as the default location. Okay, and for notification, and the upper taskbar here in the middle, where you can see the date and time, this is also the area of notification. Okay, and for notification, from setting you can choose which application is permitted to send the notification to this area. Okay, you can close the notification for a specific application or on or switch on the notification for a specific application. Okay, and now we have a search icon, and for search, read this: control which search result are shown in the activities overflow. The order of search result can also be changed by moving rows. Okay, it search on first in files and then search in applications one by one. And then we have the applications. Okay, and in application, each application has a custom configuration. Like calendar, okay, it have two configuration. One, to be available in search, and to enable configuration or disable notification or disable notification for this application, okay? And also for Google Chrome, also you will see another configuration. You have to read it one by one. And for privacy, okay, where privacy, online accounts and the sharing, these labels will be discussed in a separate video, because it really need an standalone video. Okay, and now for sound, you can control the sound here. You can add the amplification, and amplification increase the volume over the normal highest point. Okay, and also volume level of system sound, the sound of icons or clicks or whatever, and the settings for output and input and alert sounds. Next, we have the power option, power saving, blank screen after 5 minutes. You can change it, okay? And the Bluetooth will be turned off after also 5 minutes, okay? Automatic suspend is off. It will not suspend automatically, but when ideal, and ideal when there is no operation is running now, it will be automatic suspend after a specific time you will assign it from here. Okay, and now let's make it closed. And then the display to optimize your screen resolution. Okay, and choose the best resolution for your screen, and it will be chosen automatically for the first time. Okay, and we have orientation, landscape or portrait, and then mouse and touchpad. And for mouse speed, you can increase the speed of your cursor, and natural scrolling, primary button left or right. And for the Ubuntu operating system, desktop, keyboard, shortcuts, you can disable and enable these shortcuts or change it from here. Okay, and for printers, you can add a printer from here, and it will be we will add a video for printers only. Okay, and for removable devices, select how media should be installed. All media attached to your system, the setting here is to ask what to do, okay? And maybe do nothing or open this media inside file manager, okay? Or open it directly with an application, okay? For CD, maybe you are attaching an audio CD and you want it to play directly, come to settings, removable devices, CD audio, and choose the application you want to start your media with. Okay, and the four colors, okay, it is not enabled here, but it's supposed to choose the color of your of your windows, okay, and the bars and the buttons and whatever. For region and language, okay, you can this is your default system language with format, okay, and also for keyboard we have English only, and to add another language to your keyboard just click add and search for the language you want to add, okay, and if you can't see your language here, you need to click other and to set up the language you want, okay, and for me I will add Arabic language, okay, and add, and it has been added, okay, and next for universal access menu, typing and the universal access menu, when you enable it like this, you will find an menu here and you can customize which row you want to add here, okay, from the universal access menu here. Just disable it now. And users, we made a video for users and how to add a user and how to remove a user. You can refer to this video, okay. And for default applications, from here you can choose which application a specific media will start with, okay. And for example, for music, I prefer media to start up with VLC, and also for videos, okay, and for image viewer you can choose which application to be the default application for your extensions or default applications, okay. Now for date and time, you can set your time zone, okay, just like this, Cairo, Egypt, and automatic date, and it's a preferable, okay, to make it automatic, and for time format AM and PM, look at this, or 24 hours PM or AM, and this is for help information about your system, device name, Ubuntu, and memory for giga rams, and for processor we have core i5 processor and a built-in graphic, and this is the disk capacity, and operating system type, GNOME version, and Windows system, and virtualization, and the software update, okay, and this is all about system setting.